We don't actually forecast in terms of price targets, but we have a private market value for General Electric of $17 at year end 2019, growing to $19 at year end 2020. And that reflects what we think is the value that a informed industrial buyer would pay for all of GE's businesses. And so today's transaction really surfaces a lot of value in one of the high quality businesses, healthcare, which we think is worth in excess of $60 billion for GE and goes towards a large part of the $12 per share of value for aviation and healthcare, even after all debt and pension and other liabilities. So this is a very important transaction today.
Yeah, I wanted to focus in on the liabilities aspect, Justin. How important is this deal in reducing the liabilities that it has, mostly through pensions?
Sure. I think today's deal is very important. I think people had heard the message coming out of the fourth quarter that GE would look to monetize 50% of the healthcare business in the process of separating it. And there weren't specific details as to how that would happen. Now I think we have a little bit more evidence of how that will happen with the $21 billion from the sale of the biopharma business, plus whatever they may do with the remainder of the healthcare business, really can get you quickly towards, you know, half of that $60 billion or $30 billion plus, which goes a long way towards reducing their $55 billion or so net debt load, as they define it under their, you know, debt covenant agreements.
What happened to the rest of healthcare? I mean, it was thought prior to this sale that healthcare would be spun out. So now what?
Sure. I still think there's a good chance healthcare does get spun out. I think that with the cash expected to come in, you know, by the end of 2019, GE has a little bit more strategic flexibility to figure out if IPOing part of the healthcare business as part of a two-step separation remains the best course of action, or if they're merger partners for the remaining parts of the healthcare business, including the larger imaging business and what they're keeping in the life sciences business.
Justin, Culp has said we have too much debt, and 21 of that $55 billion is pension debt. So, of course, if they can show a lot of growth, those concerns are diminished. But what happens in the meantime if they, you know, they can't really reduce that, can they?
Well, they just obviously closed the Wabtec merger with their transportation business today. So they will have close to $3 billion of cash coming in the door and a monetizable stake of Wabtec by the end of the year, presumably. They'll close today's announced deal with $21 billion in cash. So that goes a long way towards reducing the debt load, and it buys them time to think about other strategic actions, but more importantly, to fix the power business,
yeah,
which along with clarifying insurance liabilities, I think are the two remaining steps to really get GE on the solid footing towards being on an improving trajectory, both balance sheet and operationally.
So final question, especially given your optimism about the stock, what do they do about power, which seems to be, you know, in facing secular challenges?
Sure. I think you can't deny that power is facing secular challenges, and because of those secular challenges, it's worth a lot less than 2 years ago. I think within the context of GE's engine expertise, particularly in the aviation business, it appears that power belongs in the portfolio, but it's important that they take care of the problems that are their own problems in terms of pricing and execution and getting that business back to a solid positive margin and free cash flow, maybe not a very high positive margin versus historical levels, but still, you know, generating cash flow and generating to the value of the underlying business.
Right.
And I think that will go a long way towards helping surface value.